I did really well, and it's unfortunate that we didn't get the W, but I think we put on a hell of a fight. I think it was the fight of the night, and I'm excited. I just can't wait to get back in the ring.
I got a couple of reactions from some fighters that were here watching this fight, and they are saying they are excited to see you whenever you fight next. Who are you looking to fight next?
Whoever Al Haymon tells me to fight next. I got a great manager. He gave me this opportunity. I know it sounds cliche, but he is the man, and he's making moves in my career.
After the, before this fight even happened, you were supposed to get the Broner fight. Do you think Broner will even fight you at 140 now?
I don't know. I'll leave that up to my manager. I think he has his hands full with Carlos Molina. I know a lot of people will say, Carlos Molina. But Carlos Molina is a good fighter. He showed his grit, and I think it's going to be a good fight for next week.
All right, thanks.
John, you said that you were the biggest, hardest punch he's ever faced. Would you say the same thing about him after this fight?
He has a good punch. I think my punch was underrated, but now that I'm at 140, I believe I belong there. And I believe my power showed.
When he went down, what was running through your mind? I mean, did you think you could finish him? How did he feel physically? I know you could kind of tell when a guy's really hurt.
I felt like I could finish him, but again, he's such an experienced veteran and been at the top of the game for a long time, and I'm just entering the top of the game. You got to proceed with caution because someone like that, there's a lot of tricks of the trade. So I wanted to proceed with caution. That's why I took my time in there. Unfortunately, it didn't work out, but I still feel like it was a great fight.
You were the first fight of the year candidate from the U.S. A lot of them have taken place in the U.K. How does that feel, even being part of such a fight? We've always talked about you being a warrior. Tonight was the best proof you could show. How does it feel being part of a fight of the year candidate?
I'm just glad that the fans now know that I do belong. I'm just glad. I mean, Lucas Matthysse, I mean, he's a hell of a puncher, hell of a warrior, and been on top of the game for a while. So I just hope you guys enjoyed it. It feels great, and I'm ready to get back in the ring.
You okay with the stoppage? I mean, I know you probably could have got up, but were you okay with the fight being called at that point?
You know, Pat Russell has to do his job. I don't argue with the referees. Their job in there is to protect the fighters, and he did a good job. So am I happy with the outcome? No, in the sense that I got the L, but I still feel that we put it all on the line, and I think we're going to do it again.
John, look at this. What do you see? You were in one of the best fights I've ever seen, fight of the year, war, and it looks like you didn't even fight tonight. What do you say about that? How do you explain that?
I know that I just know what I have and what I possess. I'm a big puncher. Lucas said I'm the hardest puncher he's ever faced. I think that speaks volumes. I mean, he's a hell of a guy and a hell of a warrior, but it feels great. There's little bumps and bruises. A lot of it was headbutts, but hey, it's part of the job, and it's what we get paid for.
A lot of experts, so-called experts, predicted that he'll blow you out between one round to two rounds. I wanted to see their face when you dropped him, not once, but twice.
Well, you know what? I needed to prove my grit. I needed to prove my will, and that's what this fight was all about. I wanted to prove I belong, and I believe that some of the naysayers now could say, you know what? John Molina is real. You know, all the naysayers of, DeMarco this, DeMarco that. With all due respect to DeMarco, I'm learning on the job. I'm ready. I'm ready for anybody at 140. We can do it again.
I spoke to a lot of people here tonight, and they told me John Molina is amazing. We can't wait to see him fight again. When are you going back into the ring? When are you stepping back in there again?
As soon as Al Haymon tells me it's time to go. I just spoke with him immediately following the fight, and we got some big things ahead and big things in store, and I'm looking to put on a good show for all the fans.
My last question, how good of a trainer is Joe Goosen?
He's a great trainer. I mean, he kept me calm in there. He did what we had to do. We almost did the job right, but almost only counts in golf, and I'm just happy everyone was safe in the fight, and I'm happy to get in the ring again.
Oh, before I forget, rematch?
Of course. So I would love to do it again.
Hey, John, you lost the fight, but do you feel you won a lot of fans?
I believe that I showed where I belong. I really do. I believe that. And I can ask you guys that because I know a lot of naysayers are out there. So, I mean, do you feel like I earned a lot of respect?
Yes, sure. Definitely. And are you going to remain at 140?
Absolutely. That's my weight. I mean, I'm a lot stronger at 140. You got to remember, we didn't just go in there and fight 140. We went in there and fought the number one rated guy at 140. And he's a hell of a fighter. We take nothing away from him, and it's all a learning experience for me. I didn't have the extensive amateur career. I got to keep re-saying that because I'm learning on the job, and I feel like I'm getting better and better as I go.
And what's next? Do you want that rematch, or would you like to get Broner?
Whatever Al Haymon has in store for us, let's do it. It's up to him. I know it sounds cliche, but he gets the job done and he makes everything happen, so I'm excited.
And what did you think of the stoppage? Did you disagree with the referee?
You can't really say anything bad about Pat Russell. He's a hell of a referee, and that's their job, is to protect the fighters. If you felt it was time to stop it, then it was time to stop it. I can't disagree or agree. I don't want to take anything away from them. They're there and there to do a job just like we are, and they did his job, and that's what happened.
And do you feel training went well with Joe Goosen?
Training went excellent with Joe Goosen. Me and him, we get along really well, and we're excited to get back to work and get on to the next fight.
And do you want to get back into the ring this year?
Absolutely. Oh, absolutely. As soon as we can, let's get back in the ring. I don't know if my wife wants me to, but Of course. No, I'm just kidding. We're going to get back in the ring. It's what we do, and I show that I prove that I belong at 140.
I want you in there fast because it makes me excited.
Yeah, yeah.
How was it fighting in there, man? This Stubbs Hub Center has been a classic for great fights. We saw another one tonight. How does it feel with the fans? Can you hear everybody? Can you see everything? Tell me how it feels being in there.
It was a great experience. I mean, Stubbs Hub Center is excellent, man. The fans come out in full force. They really support us all, and they enjoyed the fight, and they can really appreciate what we do. So I'm excited to fight at Stubbs Hub. If we do it again at Stubbs Hub, I'm all for it. It's in my backyard.
And what does it say to you when Matthysse says John Molina is the toughest guy, the hardest hitting guy I ever fought? What is it?
Well, it says to me that now I'll finally get the credit that I deserve. And when we come out, we're going to be even better again.
How did you feel when scoring those knockdowns against Matthysse?
You know what? I felt good, but I knew my power has always been legit. At 140, it's real. He knows it. He said I'm the hardest puncher he's ever faced. Yuka Morales and Yukita Morales said I'm a harder puncher than Edwin Valero. I just feel that it took a while for me to grow in the sport because, again, I didn't have the extensive amateur career. And now I'm learning on the job. I know the power I possess, but I'm starting to tighten things up a little bit, and I think I'm going to be a force to be reckoned with at 140.
Can I tell you something, John? Most time when fighters don't win, they don't talk to the media. So first, I just want to say thank you for talking to us because most of the time people just don't see or hear from them.
Well, it's like I said. Did you guys enjoy the fight?
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
absolutely.
And would you guys want to see it again?
Absolutely.
Yeah, let's do it. I mean, that's what it's all about. We're in there to put on entertainment. We're entertainers, and I believe that's what we did tonight.
Are you excited to go home and check out the fight yourself and kind of see it from your couch?
Yeah, of course I want to see the fight. I'm more excited to go home and see my little girl, you know. But, yeah, I want to go home and see the fight. I'm sure that I'm my worst critic, so I know I'm going to critique myself pretty bad, but it's a learning experience. We get up and we fight again.
How would you rate your power against Matthysse?
I think I hit like a ton of bricks. I mean, of course I'm going to say that. You know what I mean? I think if you ask around, I'm one of the hardest punchers out there at 140.
Please.
How are you feeling right now?
Hungry and thirsty.
Hey, guys, respect. You know I love all you guys, but let this man go home.
Thanks, John Molina.
John Molina Jr., stay tuned. FeeUsRootPoint.com, Vice Back Reporting.
Read. Yeah.